saw the car, right?
Oh yeah.
Yeah. What do you think the car cost to buy?
It's 85 grand.
What I'm going to say, I'm going to say around 75.
Oh, okay. But actually right now on Craigslist, it's 150 because GM has to make ventilators.
Yeah.
Corvettes.
Nope. What do you, to be honest, I'll give you the true number.
Okay.
You
okay.
won't believe it. I guarantee you won't.
I want one.
$59,000.
That's the base model
for,
one.
That is
but
that's the base model.
But he wants, which one do you want?
The 85 package or something.
He
like
wants
that.
The 85. He wants the expensive one. He
I want the red one.
A little over a year ago, Chevrolet finally revealed the all-anticipated mid-engine Corvette. And I'm talking about decades of people dreaming about this car. If Chevrolet would finally produce a vehicle that would rival the exotics, that being with engine layout. And they have finally done it. We cannot forget that reveal over in Tustin, California. There's one moment that was a drop the mic moment that just completely blew away the entire automotive scene.
What I can share with you tonight is this. When the 2020 Corvette Stingray goes on sale in the U.S., it will start at less than $60,000.
So that's pretty great.
That was when Mark Royce unveiled that this car will start at less than $60,000, making it the most affordable mid-engine supercar ever made. You're not going to believe what we have here today. We actually have the cheapest C8 Corvette in the world. This one right here, less than $60,000, specifically $59,995. People are talking about how we're never going to see a C8 Corvette that's in the 50s, actually less than 60 grand. But they're wrong. This is it right here. Now let's talk about it today. We have Shad from Chevrolet. How you doing, Shad?
I'm good.
Now you may recognize him from Jay Leno's garage. He was with Jay Leno showing off the new Corvette ZR1 back in 2019, and that's got to be fun. I've yet to drive a ZR1, but man, that looked like a lot of fun.
Well, your car's faster, so.
And this is it, right? The cheapest one in the world. And just looking at it, it looks so similar to mine. It's the same body, right? But what makes it cost so much less versus what we have right here?
Yeah, you're right. So all of the body panels are the same, and it is essentially the same car. And everything from the motor, the 6.2 liter V8, the DCT, the transmission, all of that is the same thing that's in your car.
So Shad, I'm trying to think. So mine is a 2LT, this being a 1LT. What are the main differences we're gonna find with this car?
Well, as you know, you can pretty much customize these cars to be whatever you want. So this does not have, for instance, things like heated or cooled seats. It doesn't have the HD rear view mirror. It doesn't have the front splitter that you have. The brakes are standard brakes. These are, you know, 5-spoke silver wheels, but you still get 19 and 20 inch. So from a cosmetic standpoint on the outside, it looks the same until you get it to the Z51 performance package.
Speaking about how it does not have the HD rear view camera, it's completely flat right there versus mine that has that bump right there in the middle. So overall though, it's just creature comforts. The car itself, if you want the lightest variant possible, this would be it, right?
This is it, yeah.
This is it.
It's a 3,500 pounds.
Oh my gosh. This being a non-Z51 car, doesn't have MagnaRide with it, right? So it's got the stock suspension.
Correct.
And do you notice a big difference with that, you think?
Driving on the highway and in city streets, you don't really notice the difference. You take it to a track, that's where the difference comes
in. Okay, so if you want to track this car, you might want to put in the extra money for that. This having 5 less horsepower, does it really affect, you think, accelerating off a line? Is it much slower with the less horsepower
and
the less sticky tires?
0 to 60 in this car is 3 seconds.
It looks so similar to mine. I think that the looks, if anyone saw this driving down the road, they're not going to realize it costs, I think, $22,000 less than mine.
Yeah, that's the best part. You just have performance bits on your car that makes it look a little bit different.
Yeah, like the high wing. That high wing was, I think, $1,200, having no wing in the back. That is pretty interesting. It makes the style on that is really nice, actually.
Yeah, but it's not one of those things that it looks worse.
Yeah.
It's just different. It's cleaner, some might say, and there's no compromise on it. And that's the best part about the entry-level vehicle, is that you don't feel like you're buying the cheapest version.
Does it affect performance much, you think? Like, let's say top speed. This would probably beat my car, right? Knowing that I have all that extra drag and downforce in the back compared to this.
Yeah, I mean, at top speed, I don't know what the top speed on this particular version is, but you're right, you have a little bit more drag on yours. It's the same exact motor, it's the same exact transmission. This has 490 horsepower compared to your 495, and that's because of the exhaust.
And can you notice the exhaust at all?
Not from the outside. No, you can't see any difference on the outside.
Okay, so then if you go to a car show or car meet, no one will ever know, right?
Not until we fire them up.
And do they sound different, actually?
Yeah, yeah. When you're in sport mode and you power yours up, your exhaust is open.
So, oh yeah, and also I'm noticing it doesn't have the carbon fiber. That's extra accessories again. So, you can really get this car down in price, and the performance of it's still so similar, it seems like. And plus, you still have that mid-engine right there. So I guess it really doesn't look like a base engine to me, though. That's the interesting part that's really hitting me right now.
That's the idea, is that we wanted, that's always been the Corvette promise, right? Is that you could get a supercar at an attainable price. That's always been what Corvette has been about. And I think that was the biggest worry among some of the Corvette enthusiasts when we talked about the mid-engine Corvette was, they're gonna price out of my range.
And then not just that, for year two, it's the same price, right?
Yeah.
So here we are hopping inside the base Stingray that costs less than $60,000 right away. I'm noticing the Bose speaker does not look the same. Mine is, it's got a finished brushed metal on it. How many speakers is this, you know?
Eight.
Eight, okay. So that's still good enough, I think. Do these mirrors, they fold in at all? Because there's one less button on this side.
They're just not electric. You can pull it in.
Okay, that makes sense then. Well, okay. So there's one button right there in front of the mode selector. So basically that is, so it's traction control, and that's because we don't have the cameras up front, and then no front end lift with it. And moving this way, there's less buttons as well. So this would be the heated and cooled seats, right?
That's correct.
Over here?
Yep.
But is that all the differences that we're gonna notice, you think, inside?
Yeah, except for your rearview mirror.
Let's start it up. This is going to be very interesting because I've never experienced this car without the Z51 Performance Package and also the MagnaRide. And even this car has the less sticky tires, the all-season tires, which makes sense for what it is. So let's go and drive. Is it? It's in sport mode right now, right?
It is.
And this is still telescoping, right? Okay, so it moves. That's nice. The one thing I love with this car is that I can't find any like shortcuts. Everything feels high quality with it. Feels very similar. Feels like almost the exact same car basically so far. And think about how it costs 20 grand less, I think, than mine. It is just so shocking to me. Do you think many people are going to order this car and in this form at all?
Yeah, I mean, one of the changes for the 2021 model year is that you can now add the magnetic ride to this level. So that seems to be one of the most popular options that people are asking for. So yeah, I think that they will.
And you know what, these GT1 seats, they actually feel pretty comfortable. I wasn't sure what they'd be like because they have the competition seats, those seats, they hold you in really tight on the sides. This is like, you can just relax with this. You can go cross country easily.
Yeah, that's the name of the game. Comfort with this vehicle.
Comfort? Well, it comes off very luxurious. I hear a lot of comments here and there about how it doesn't feel too raw. And I think for what it offers, you just gotta change it in a drive mode. The next you know, you're in loud exhaust mode, the suspension stiffens up. So it's one of those things that if you want a daily driver, this can easily do that. The next, you know, if you want to have fun, just, you know, put in manual mode, downshift the gear, put in loud mode, and then you're all good to go. Driving up and down the coast right here, I don't think anyone would ever tell. Again, this is the base model Corvette, because it drives so similarly, and it looks just like it. Since it has the normal exhaust, is it always in loud mode, or is it always in normal sound?
It's as if you had your car in touring mode.
Okay.
Always.
So would this car do the pops and the upshifts?
Correct. A little, well, it will a little bit.
You know, they finally got it right.
You think so?
Yeah, because some of them, they always look so damn big and stuff, you know what I mean? Where they just, these are this mid-engine, this is so bitching.
No, how much? $59,000.
They're bitching. You know what it is? They almost look like a Ferrari. Because I just live around here, and I was going to the post office, and I saw the red one. I go, well, shit, I hope it's still there when I get back. It's really
No,
they're just bitch. Hey, you two gentlemen, enjoy them, huh?
Thank you.
It was nice chatting with you, huh?
You know what, Chad, I am thoroughly impressed. You know, I really appreciate you letting me have the chance to drive this car, because I was really curious in how it was going to drive compared to my car, because I know I've really optioned mine out with all the accessory options like the suede interior, the suede steering wheel, stuff like that.
You don't regret paying more for your car, do you?
Oh no, I'm happy I did that. I'll happily pay even more, because I like the options. I like the stuff you can do with this car. It's one of those things, when it comes to ordering a C8, you're probably not going to see the same car twice, because there's so much you can do with it.
You see him taking your picture?
Wait, was?
Yeah.
Taking a photo?
Yeah.
Porsche right there. And just thinking about it, Chad, this car, again, so $60,000 mid-engine, 3 seconds 0-60 with it. Well, what is the closest mid-engine car like this? What is it, like the NSX and the Audi R8, and those cars are $100,000 or more.
Yeah, and we'll beat them.
That's the mindset. I think everybody's super excited to not just see this, though, but the next variant's coming out, and also, like the convertible, production, has that started yet for that vehicle?
We start production at the end of this year.
Okay.
And we'll start doing deliveries right after that.
That should be very rare, thinking about it, because 2020 is going to go down as a very interesting year for Corvette.
Oh.
It's, man, I think if people have an order secured for that car, the convertible, it's going to pop. It doesn't feel like the base model anything. It really comes together very nicely. I think anyone who does order this, you're going to be really blown away. You're going to be really happy with how it turned out. Chad, I really appreciate it again, man. Really impressed with this car. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching this video. If you liked it, make sure to hit that like button. It really helped me out. Also, subscribe for much more great C8 Corvette content coming your way. I'll see all of you in the next episode.